Hello, I am Robyn Porter with Long & Foster Real Estate. It is Tuesday evening, July 8th. Okay, wait, it's July 7th. Sorry about that. And we're having a storm right now, and I'm supposed to be doing my Ask Me Anything Real Estate Edition, and there is thunder and lightning going on right. Hold on, I think it's gonna work. Hopefully it's not going in and out for you guys. We're only gonna do this for a half an hour, and hopefully it'll work and the storm is not gonna knock out any sort of connection that I have. But I am coming to you from my home in Montgomery County, Maryland, and I am here to answer all of your real estate questions. So if you have one, please just put it down in the comment section. I'll be able to see it and then answer what you have. I did have earlier today, I had someone send me a couple questions so we can go over those. But just to give you a little background on me, if you're not familiar with me, I have been selling real estate since 2004 with Long & Foster Real Estate, and my office is in Bethesda on Sangamore Road, and I'm licensed in DC, Maryland. It went out again. What you guys are seeing, but it keeps saying trying to reconnect. Hopefully it's working. And again, apologies for the technical difficulty. It's been super hot. Yesterday we had crazy storms that went well into the night, and they're starting again, but I guess that's summer in DC. So again, I am Robyn Porter, Long & Foster Real Estate, licensed in DC, Maryland, and Virginia. I work with all sorts of buyers, from first-time home buyers to experienced buyers. Love answering questions, and happy to answer whatever you may have. I see some people are joining us. Hi, Denise, how are you? One of the questions I had earlier today was a buyer who, and by the way, hopefully people are attending anywhere from DC, Maryland, and Virginia to people across the country, because no matter where you are, I can help you with your real estate needs. And this particular question came from someone in the Midwest, and she is thinking about selling her home, and she was wondering about how does you stage your home and sell your home while living in the home. And I have to say, you know, it's definitely challenging. And this particular person is a single mom and she has three kids. So she's got a lot going on in her life. Now, what I tell folks when they're thinking about putting their home on the market is, if you're about to move, you're gonna have to pack up stuff anyway. So at this point, if I were you, I would allow yourself a couple weeks and pack up pretty much everything you need everything that you need that won't be staged, or keep the things that you need for staging, pack up everything else. That's really what I'm trying to get out of my mouth. Sorry about that. So get a pod, have it parked outside of your home, and just start loading it up, because you want to, when you're staging your home for sale, you want your home to be showcased in its best light. And you know, all the clutter, if you have clutter, if you have too many pictures on the walls, and by the way, get rid of all of your personal photos, people can't see past your stuff and imagine their things in the home. So it's really important for you to just pack all that stuff up. You'll see it in a few weeks in your new home, but you don't need it. Now, if you have little kids, they have some toys that they like, leave out, you know, their favorite toys, but pack up everything else. And you know what, when you get to your new destination, it's going to be so exciting for them, because they'll see toys that they haven't seen in a while and they'll be really excited. So they might cry about it for a day, you know, where's their little stuffed doll or toy or whatever, but then when they get to their new house, they'll see it, it'll be great, and they'll be like the holidays getting some presents. Another thing about staging that's super important is things like personal photos, money, bills, checks, things like that, prescriptions in your medicine cabinet, all of that stuff needs to be put away. Give it to a friend, a relative, pack it up in a safe, anything like that, especially financial related matters, prescriptions, and put it away. Because I'm just telling you, people will steal your stuff. They do. They steal it. I don't know why, but people are stealing stuff like that. It's crazy. But you know, you don't want the inconvenience of that. You don't want someone stealing your identity. So that's kind of my staging thing. And with the photos, people don't, we're living in crazy times. People, you know, they'll come in, and I have horror stories. I don't have time to tell you my horror stories, but I have horror stories, truly like crime horror stories. People don't need to know that you have kids. So take your kid photos, take your wedding photos, pack them up, stick a picture of a dog somewhere, you know, or, you know, if you want a picture of a person, take the one that's in that frame that you buy at the store when you buy your frame, put that out somewhere. That's all you need. So that's sort of my staging advice. And so then I had another question about somebody who, this is from a buyer, and a lot of buyers are buying homes, let me take that back. They're finding homes online, and then they're like, how do I actually buy the home? So this is somebody who does not have a real estate agent, and they're thinking, okay, you know, everyone thinks they can, you know, do it themselves. You can't. And so they've been online searching the internet, and they found a really great home, and they're like, okay, great. I went to the open house, virtual, could have been a virtual open house, could have gone in person. And they think, okay, I want the house. How do I get the house? Well, this is where a real estate agent comes in super handy. Now, in the DC, Virginia, and Maryland area, buyer representation is typically paid for by the selling broker agency through an agreement that the seller has made with the listing agent. So basically, buyer representation doesn't cost a buyer anything. So it behooves you to have representation. Now, I will tell you that if you are online, if you found a home, you went to the open house, you're like, great. You talk to the agent at the open house and you say, you know what, this is the house I want. I want this place. Make no mistake, that agent sitting in that open house represents the seller. They don't represent you. They can't represent you. In Maryland, we call that dual agency, and it's actually illegal in Maryland. So again, if you have them write a contract for you or an offer to purchase the home, they're not representing you. They're actually representing the seller. So get an agent, and then your agent can help you get the property. And a lot of people think, okay, so my home is under contract and I finally got the home, we're under contract. What happens? And a lot of people think that's the end of it. That, my friends, is just the beginning of a very long road from getting under contract going all the way to settlement. There's financing issues that need to be met. If you have a financing contingency, you have to make sure you're getting all of your financial information to your lender. Maybe there's a home inspection. Maybe there's an appraisal. Maybe radon is, you know, a big test here in Montgomery County, Maryland, that sellers need to do a radon test. What if you have radon in the home? What other things go on? What if the seller needs a rent back? What if you want to move in before you go to settlement? There are so many things that can happen between the contract and settlement. And this is why you need a real estate agent. And it just, it bamboozles me why sellers think that it's all about just getting a contract, because it's not. It's a lot more than that. So find yourself a really good real estate agent. So, which leads me to a whole other thing. Like, how do you find a real estate agent? Ask your friends. If they don't know, search the internet. Go to Yelp, go to Google, and look at people's reviews, and ask questions. You know, buying a home is a very personal experience, and you're gonna be sharing personal information with somebody, sharing, spending a lot of time with that person, and they're gonna know everything about you. So you really want to make sure you click. I kind of think it's a little like dating, in that, you know, you gotta have a good vibe. You gotta have a good, mojo with your agent, because if you don't, it's not gonna be a good experience. I'm a firm believer in delivering good and bad news at the same speed. And sometimes agents just yes you to death, they try and sell you a house. You don't wanna be sold a house. You want them to help you find a home that you love. And that's a good real estate agent. And if you're not feeling that, like that good vibe, that good mojo, you got a good thing going, find yourself another agent. You can fire your agent, just so you know, you can. Okay, so I have a question coming in, and it says, I gotta put my glasses on for this one, people. It's gotten a part of my life. Okay, if I see a home for sale by owner, can I still use your services or do I need to work directly with the seller? Great question. So again, yes. In fact, I think that, so a FSBO, for sale by owner, means that the seller does not want to work with a real estate agent at all. And how it would work is if I'm representing a buyer, I would contact the seller ahead of time and let them know that I am representing the seller, representing the buyer, and if I could bring them to the home, and then I would work out a situation where the seller would pay for my representation of the buyer. And I would say there's only been one instance where the buyer ended up paying my commission. And that was because, in that very specific situation, that particular buyer client of mine was driving along, saw a for sale by owner, knocked on the door, viewed the home, and didn't tell me until he left and said I wanted to buy the home. So that was kind of a unique situation. But in most instances, the seller will pay the commission. And then what typically happens is that I would represent the buyer, and I do, you know, a lot of ministerial acts that, you know, helped for the seller that helped to move the contract forward. So, let me just wave hi to a couple people that have signed in. And, if you have questions, please let me know, write them in the comments. I'm happy to answer. And just to recap, my name is Robyn Porter and I work with Long and Foster Real Estate, and I have been selling homes in DC, Maryland, and Virginia since 2004. I work with both buyers and sellers, across from first-time home buyers all the way to seasoned buyers, people that are downsizing, people that are retiring, estate sales. I've had people that have passed away in homes. I've had first-time home buyers, which I love working with. And I know that this is going to sound a little cheesy, but it's true. And it's going to sound really Hallmarky, but I tell this to everybody. You never have a second chance to buy your first home. So you want to make sure that that is a great experience and you're working with someone that you feel like is really going to represent you, because that transaction is really going to set the tone and feel for all of your transactions going forward. I don't know if you hear the storm going on outside my home, but it's thundering and lightning, and I'm very happy that so far we've not disconnected again. If you have any questions, please let me know. I'll be on, you know, as long as the questions go. And so let's see, another question that I get a lot is, do I need to speak with a lender before I look for a home? And that is a resounding yes, 100%. In fact, I think in many instances, it's more important to speak with a lender before you speak with a real estate agent. If you don't know who to speak with in terms of a mortgage lender, your real estate agent can point you in the right direction. I have a few that I definitely recommend. But the mortgage is so important because, one, you might be, you got to get, ooh, did you hear that thunder? Woo! Crazy thunder right now. It's really blowing. It's blowing. Trees are blowing. Rain's about to be unleashed. But it would be great for my garden. I've been waiting for my tomatoes to ripen. Anyway, so getting a mortgage, why it's so important is because you want to get pre-approved before you look for a home. Pre-approvals are so important for so many reasons. First and foremost, you want to make sure that you can afford the home that you're looking for. The worst thing is to go out and look at a home and then realize, and it's your dream home. And you're like, this is it. I gotta have this home. And then you realize you can't afford it. Also, perhaps there is a dream home and you're thinking, I really want that home, and you think you can afford it. And then all of a sudden you talk to the lender, you can. So it's just really important. And if you maybe you've talked to a lender and you might have some financial challenges. I have an itchy nose, sorry. Maybe you have some financial challenges in your background that you need to address before you can actually purchase a home. So whether you're looking now or in a year, get your financial house in order. So, a lender will run your credit report, maybe there's a ding on your credit you need to resolve, and then they'll push up your number and you get a better interest rate. So talking with the lender is so key. In fact, I personally, in my business, I won't even take a buyer out looking at homes unless they have been pre-approved and I've had an opportunity to speak with the lender. It's just good business. Let's make sure we're, moving in the right direction. You got pre-approved. And then once you are pre-approved, especially in the DC market, we are so competitive in the DC market that you need to have a pre-approval letter when you make an offer. So when you make an offer in the DC, Maryland, or Virginia area, there are three components that make up your offer. The first one are the offer documents, which also include the property disclosures. So that's one component. Then the other component is your earnest money deposit. And then your third component is the pre-approval letter that tells the seller you have talked with a mortgage guy or gal and you filled out the application. And hopefully you've already given them your financial information. So those three pieces make up your offer. Now, this is just totally a bias thing for me. And let me just tell you, a buyer can use any lender they prefer. Big, small, whatever. They can use any lender they prefer. I strongly encourage a smaller regional lender that's a little more nimble and can move quickly, because there is nothing more frustrating than trying to get a hold of a lender on a Sunday afternoon at 3:00 and you're trying to put together offer docs and that person's at the beach or on the golf course and you can't reach them. I don't have time for that, especially in the busy market. Your lender should be available all the time. Within reason, I'm thinking until 9:00 during the week, and on the weekends, maybe till 7 or 8. And then in the morning, beginning at like 9 or 10. It's just, that's the market. And when there are offer deadlines and you need pre-approval letters or, now you find out there's an escalation clause, so you need your pre-approval letter rewritten, you just need a very responsive lender. So that's sort of my lender spiel. I think it's super important. And, talk with the lender and then we can go look in a home. Let's see. Oh, got more people. Hello. I love people joining me. Thanks so much, everybody, by the way, for supporting me. And if anyone out there has any questions, even after this evening, about buying or selling a home, staging a home, mortgage, anything you got, feel free to DM me, send me an email. Happy to help. I make myself you'd be surprised how available I make myself with the text. You ever want to get a hold of me? You send me a text. It's pretty good, unless I'm out, in the barn with my goats. You get an answer pretty quickly back from me. So feel free to reach out anytime on any topic real estate related. And if you have a friend, a coworker, a family member that's thinking about buying or selling a home, happy to help them. And even if it's just answering questions, they might not be ready now, but might be ready in a year. Happy to help. Not a problem at all. So let's see. I feel like I've been talking forever. Let me just take a little swig of the water as the storm is coming in. I have a dry throat. Hold on. Oh, that's refreshing. Trying to think, I don't see many questions coming in, but I love the fact that people are viewing. So that's awesome. Let's see. I get this question a lot. It's either like, how long should I look at homes, or how many homes should I look at before I pick one? The answer really is sort of a gut feeling. There is no right answer on how many homes you should look at before you pick one. True story, I took a first-time home buyer, guy, out in DC. We were looking at homes. We took him out one day at lunch on his lunch break. Looked at three homes, he picked one, done. Got the home. It could be that short. Some people take longer. Some people just walk into a place and know, like, that's my home. I'm gonna take that home. Let's get it. Let's go. But some people just, it takes them longer. They need a feeling. They're trying to find the perfect home. Sometimes the perfect home is almost perfect, and you can make it perfect with a very little effort. But it doesn't matter whether, you know, you're looking at two homes, you're looking at 20 homes, whatever it works for you is how many you need to look at. So, and my other thing, I was talking with some couple buyers today. They found me on the internet and we did an initial consultation call. And one of my big pieces of advice is, especially when you're buying your first home, everybody wants to give you advice. It's great. Take it. Don't internalize it too much. Listen to them just out of respect. But at the end of the day, you're paying the mortgage. And if you like the home for whatever reason you like it, go with that home. Again, unless they're paying your mortgage, just enjoy the conversation you're having with them. But really, everybody will give you their two cents, and it only needs to feel right to you for sure, 100%. So that's kind of my thought there. Another question I get is, how long does it take to actually buy a home? And generally speaking, from the time you actually have a ratified contract, and a ratified contract means the buyer and the seller have agreed, and you're gonna, you know, you're moving forward with the contingencies. So the buyer and seller have agreed. It usually takes about 30 days from that point until settlement. Now, sometimes it can go a little longer. It's very rare, at least in my experience. Everything I'm talking about is from my experience. It's very rare to go longer than that, like 45 days to settlement. There's, you know, usually, I don't know, maybe someone's traveling or something like that. It's rare. Now, I can tell you that, especially in the DC market where it's super busy and competitive, that sometimes the 30 days is compacted down to 2 weeks. It happens more than you think. And so that's another reason why using a smaller local lender that's a little more nimble, can move quickly, is why, you know, you should use one of these smaller lenders, is because if you, you know, if you're comparing apples to apples and it's a competitive offer, you're trying to make your offer look so great that it's rising to the top. And one of the ways you can do is have a quick settlement, because then the seller's out of that house, they're not making another mortgage payment, and it's just more money in the seller's pocket. It's not, you know, it's not gonna harm you, because your first mortgage payment isn't due until up to 45 days until after you go to settlement. So, you know, a speedy settlement is great. So typically about 30 days, sometimes 45, many times shorter than that. So that is, you know, how long that takes. So I am going to sign off unless anybody has another question and just wants to pass it along. And I'm trying to like wave hi to a couple people that have joined, and my phone's not doing that. Anyway, thank you for joining for this edition of Ask Me Anything Real Estate. And I am fully available offline. DM me anytime to answer your real estate related questions. And I hope to talk with you in the future. And I'm very happy to help your friends, family, coworkers buy or sell a home, DC, Maryland, and Virginia. And I can also help you if you're moving out of state, by the way. My BFF lives in Chicago. She's a great person to help you in the northern suburbs of Chicago. But Long & Foster also has a reach across the United States. And I can help you across the United States. So anyway, have a great day. I'm going to go listen to the storm a little longer. Who doesn't love a good rainstorm? And in the meantime, stay happy, stay healthy. See you soon.